my friends, welcome back to our channel. Today we're gonna solve problems related to equilibrium of bodies. So without losing time, let's get started. In our first example, we have a box wrench and we wanna tighten the bolt at point A. To tighten, you rotate clockwise and to open, it's in counterclockwise direction. If the wrench does not turn when the load is applied to the handle as in figure, determine the moment applied to the bolt and also the force of the wrench on the bolt. It is possible to find these values because when we apply force and the object doesn't move, there is an equilibrium, and Newton's third law says that the reaction is equal to action. So, moment on the bolt is equal to the moment that we make with our hands, so does the force. Let me note that point A is fixed, which means that it doesn't rotate. It will have resisting moment not to do so. Before starting to solve these kind of problems, first write down procedures. They will guide you when solving them. Additionally, procedures gonna make your problems look simpler. First procedure is drawing a free body diagram. Free body diagram will simplify your figures. Second, clarify positive sign convention. It doesn't matter which direction is positive for you, it is just assumption. But we have to do that, not to confuse us. Generally, I clarify positive signs in this way, for a moment it is counterclockwise. Third, if needed, divide the force into components. If the force is not perpendicular to the moment arm, in other words, if it is a diagonal, then we have to divide it into components. That way, we make it easier to find total force in X and Y direction, and also it makes easier to find moment. By the way, a moment arm is simply the length between a joint axis, here it is point A, and the line of force acting on that joint, which we can show here that it is B and C. Fourth one is writing down equilibrium equations. We all know equilibrium equations from our previous lectures. And fifth one, final one, is just solving them.
Just do it!
Let's start by drawing free body diagram. On B, C and A we have forces, but A has additional moment. If you notice it, I choose negative sides for both forces and for moment as well. It doesn't matter which direction you choose when solving unknowns, because final results will be the same, don't worry about it. Second, clarify positive sign convention. Here it is right side for X and upwards for Y direction and counterclockwise for moment. Our third procedure was to divide into components. I see here that both forces are not perpendicular to moment arm, so I have to do that. I have to divide into components. Calculating magnitude of components are very easy if you know simple rules of trigonometry. For the force acting on B, Y component will be 12 over 13 times resultant force, which is 52 here. Maybe you wonder where does this 12 over 13 come from? It comes from this little triangle that I highlighted above. It is a Pythagorean triangle, and to find any component, let's say in this case Y component, we just divide magnitude of Y component to the hypotenuse. That is how we get 12 over 13. Now we can easily find X component as well by looking at triangle. It will be 5 over 13 times 52 newtons, and results are 48 newton and 20 newton respectively.
For the force acting on C, component in Y direction will be sine 60 times 30 and component in X direction will be cosine 60 times 30. Results will be 25.98 newtons and 15 newtons respectively.
After finding components, we can delete resultant forces, just not to disturb us. Our final procedure was to write down equilibrium equations and finding unknown reactions. If we start by writing equilibrium equations for X direction, I know that sum of total force in X direction must be zero. From left to right we have positive 15 newton because it is rightwards, negative 20 newton and negative AX as they both point leftwards. From this equation, I find that AX is equal to minus 5 newtons. So far, so good. I know also that sum of total forces in Y direction must be zero. From left to right, we have 25.98 newtons, minus 48 newtons, and also minus Ay. I guess you know why I put minus sign in front of them. From this equation, I find that Ay is minus 73.98 newtons. For the moment, let me clear this side. It was asked to find moment that is applied to the bolt. I can write moment equation at any point, but I decide to write it at point A. Even if you take moment about point B or C, you will get same results. I mean, you will get same magnitude and direction for the moment at bolt. First, let's see which forces cause moment at point A. In other words, which forces try to rotate point A. Forces at point A have line of action that passes through A. They don't try to rotate, they just simply try to push or pull. Same things for BX and CX as well. Then we are left with minus 25.98 times perpendicular distance, which is 0.7 meters. This force tries to rotate point A in clockwise direction, and we have also minus 48 times 0.3 meters. And finally, we add moment of bolt itself. As they are all in clockwise direction, we put minus sign in front of them. Solve this equation and you get for moment A 32.6 newton meters. I use it newton and meter as units, so the result will be in that units. I want to show you final free body diagram with numbers on it. To do that, first let me write results that I got. In previous videos, we learned that we can easily get rid of minus sign in vectors if you want to. Some people like doing it, including me, so by changing directions of vectors I can get rid of minus sign, but magnitudes don't change. If you don't want to change the direction, you just write your minus sign in front of them, simple as that. This example looks like a complicated one, but don't be afraid, it is not. We have been asked to find reactions at A and B. Remember our procedures. First, draw a free body diagram. By looking closer to supports, I come to decision that A is pinned support, and it is represented in this way, and support at B is roller support. I know this because the bottom of support in figure is circular, which tells me that it is a roller one. To understand supports and their directions, watch our previous video, and you can find that video in our description as well. Show all forces on free body diagram. Let me ask you, why we identified supports, like is it a roller support, a pinned support? Simply to know how supports react. Pinned support has force in X and in Y direction, but roller support has just only one and it is in Y direction. Second, specify positive directions. Third procedure was divided into components, but we don't need that because all forces are perpendicular to the moment arm. And last, solve equilibrium equations for X. We just have only two forces in total, positive 5 kN and negative Ax. From here I get 5 kN for Ax. Positive result means that I don't have to change direction. For Y, we have 4 forces in total from left to right. Positive By, negative 8 and 6 kN, and Ay in positive direction. From this equation I get sum of By and Ay as 14 kN. We have two unknowns but one equation. But I know that I can also write equilibrium equation for moment at any point, thus I can decrease unknowns. I decide to write at point A. For point A, By causes rotation in counterclockwise direction, so it is positive, but all other three forces try to rotate in clockwise direction, so they are negative. Forces at point A does not cause rotation, they pass through point itself, meaning they don't rotate point A. Calculating this, I get B as 9 kN. In previous equation that I couldn't solve because I had two unknowns, now I can subtract By into that equation and get 5 kN for Ay. Before finishing our video, I want to give conceptual example for you, my friends, to solve, to ponder on it. Where to put all the mud or soil to minimize the load on the back of the person? Like, I mean, does the load need to be closer to the cartwheel or to the person? and in our next video we're gonna explain it and solve it. Hope you enjoyed our video. Don't forget to like and write your opinions in comments below. See you guys.